All right, hello cadets. This is Dr. Cook with the MS-200. I'm going to give you a phase one review to help you prep for the upcoming WPR. All right, so in this block, we have talked about how to do a task org, how to do area of operation and area of interest, along with our AO overlay. We've talked about doing a terrain analysis using OACOC and how to make a graphical terrain analysis overlay, and then how to do light and weather analysis. All right, make sure on your task org you include a task and purpose. If you know it, at least for the platoon, it goes up in the upper corner. All right, make sure you have the right echelon symbols. Okay, 3 dots for the platoon, 1 dot for the squad, and that little circle with a slash for the team. All right, make sure you use the right unit type. All right, in the correct shape and color. All right, blue for friendly. And then we got things like the cross lines for infantry. We've got armor, mechanized infantry, so an infantry symbol with the track vehicle there, all right? Striker with the wheeled armored vehicle here. Engineers, the sideways E. This is a anti-tank, and this one happens to be motorized, so on Humvees, all right? Make sure you use the correct modifiers that go inside of that, all right? The L for light, you've got weapon. Air assault's a little V-looking one, airborne, all right? Mountain, the triangle, parachute with a little ice cream cone there. This one's toad, all right? Those are some common ones you should know. There's a lot of others in the book, all right? So make sure you have the correct modifier. Make sure you put a unit name up there, all right, as much as you know. And your key weapon symbols, make sure you study up on what those are so that you know the common ones that we've been using, like the machine guns, what machine guns are light or medium or heavy. Anti-tank weapons, anti-tank missiles versus rockets, that you know those things. And then your attached assets. Make sure your task org is including your attached assets as well. All right, your AO and AI, you can discuss those, understanding where your area of operation is and how to brief that. The area of interest, all right? Using that CAR acronym for CAS Artillery Reserves, and then thinking about what could they do to you, all right? What can they do to you? That's the important part. Focus your AI about what can they do to you. All right, here are the overlay markings that need to be on every overlay. All right, make sure that you have all of these. Go back and reference our material classifications, top and bottom. You have to have at least two. You can have more, but at least two reference grids to line it up, north seeking arrow, and then the index information over here with the name or the purpose of the overlay, your map that you're using, who did it, that's your name, a date time group so we know which one's most current, and then the classification goes over in that corner also. So you got to have that information on the overlays. And all these markings should be in black. Your terrain analysis, all right? Big thing there is make sure you focus on the so what. I know that you all understand the idea of what OAKOC stand for. Describing it, I think most of you are gonna find pretty easy. But you gotta start thinking about what is the effect of that description on the enemy, or what is that effect on me? It might be an effect on both of us. And then following from that, the big next step is that so what, the deduction, all right? And that so what is about what's gonna change about how I do my mission. All right, how does it impact my mission and make me do something different? What can I do? What can I do? All right, GTAOs. All right, make sure you include all those standard overlay markings. All right, and then the three big things you need to have is your terrain classifications. All right, restricted and severely restricted terrain in green. All right, your key terrain marked off in purple, or if you don't have purple, black is acceptable. All right, and then your avenues of approach for both friendly and enemy, and those go in blue and red, all right? Your avenues of approach are the ways, the avenues, the paths that can get you to, and here's the key part, avenues of approach lead to key terrain or the objective, all right? Avenues of approach don't just go off somewhere that we don't need to be, all right? The enemy's avenues of approach, if they're in a fixed defense, it's their avenues out of there. All right, and if they're in some kind of meeting battle, it can be approaches towards you, all right, or how can a reserve force approach to get into you and interfere with your mission, all right? So for the enemy, that's how you got to think about it. All right, five aspects of military weather, wind, precipitation, cloud cover, temperature, humidity, and visibility. All right, so you should be able to take weather and light information and talk about those five aspects. All right, and how do they interfere with your mission? Again, we're getting back to that so what concept, not just what they are. We don't just say there's 5 mile an hour winds, okay, or there's 40 mile an hour winds. Well, what does that mean? Well, 40 mile an hour winds with high gusts, that means we can't fly aircraft. That might impact the enemy because they can't use their CAS, or it might impact us because we can or can't, things like that. Please don't get further into it than just saying, well, it's going to rain, so we need to bring our wet weather gear. All right, always bring your wet weather gear. All right, that's not what we need to know. We need to know that how it's going to interfere with our ability to do the mission. It's going to slow us down. It's going to make our aim not as good. It's going to decrease our visibility. And then the visibility distances impacts how close we have to get to the enemy before we can engage. All right, think like that, but be able to think about it and talk about it in terms of those five aspects: wind, precipitation, cloud cover, temperature, humidity, and visibility. All right, cadets, that's the end of the review. Hope to see you all at the next lesson, and we'll have a great WPR, and I want everybody to just crush this thing, and we'll achieve excellence in this course.